Now, if you played MLB The Show 17, 18, or 19, you're going to be given a legacy reward pack in which you will have to choose between Ken Griffey Jr., Aaron Judge, or Bryce Harper. Now, if you're new here and up enjoying today's content, please make sure to hit that like button, red subscribe button, turn on the notification bell, follow me on all social medias at Blademus, same way it's spelled on the YouTube channel username, and also make sure to click on the YouTube channel username, go to the community tab, and vote on what you want to see next whenever it is asked. Now, when looking at these cards, you can almost make a prediction on how they will look in terms of archetypes. For example, Ken Griffey Jr. most likely going to be the more balanced one out of all of them when it comes to his attributes, and then Aaron Judge is most likely to be a power hitter. Bryce Harper most likely to be balanced out, similar to Ken Griffey Jr., except with worse speed, worse fielding, and then everything else I'd say will pretty much align with one another. Now, if you want to know who you should pick from a competitive standpoint, I'd always go with Ken Griffey Jr. because he's the more balanced one all around. He can play center field as opposed to Bryce Harper and Aaron Judge, who can only play right field. And you will most likely be able to find a better corner fielder that is a gold than either of them. Not only that, but regardless, when looking at these cards, you'll most likely replace them in a week, so they probably wouldn't stay in your lineup for a while. But if you had to choose one, I'd go with Ken Griffey Jr. He's the only card that does not currently, that we know of, have a card for you to use in the game to start off with besides that one. Aaron Judge has a Life Series card, and so does Bryce Harper. Now, let's talk about Battle Royale. Now, I do a no money spent series, and if you're new here, you don't know what that series is. It's basically where we have a team full of common players, the lineup, bench, starting pitchers, and bullpen arms, and the only way we can replace those common players is by going on battle royale runs and winning battle royale games and getting the battle royale rewards. So if we go 12 and 0, we would get the 3-game reward, 6-game reward, 9-game reward, 12-game reward, and the flawless pack reward, and we would all replace common players with basically whoever we got from those packs. And that is how we build a team, and at the end of every single ranked seasons, when there's a week left, we try to hit World Series with that team. Now, this is going to be the first year that we're actually going to be starting this off right off the bat. Usually, I wait until they make diamonds at 9 wins, but since it's starting off instantly in the year, we're going to be doing it off the jump. Now, this is going to be a separate series. I personally never spend money on MLB The Show, and to this day, and until Friday, or even beyond Friday, I still won't spend any money. The only difference is that this team will be constructed strictly off of Battle Royale, and then I will have a ranked team that will include all the XP rewards and everything. But when looking at the flawless players pool, if you ask me to give you guys my rankings in order from 1 through 5, the number one option out of all of them is going to be that Andrew Miller. Why? He's a lefty bullpen arm. This game lacks good lefty diamonds. Not only that, but pitcher's energy makes this game insanely different. No pitcher roulette makes this game also insanely different. The fact you can use openers, it just adds an immense amount of value to not only bullpen arms, but to starting pitchers in general. So that's why I say Andrew Miller is number one. Number two would be Trevor Hoffman, if he's a really good card. And then number three, I would give it to Jim Edmonds because he always has the glitchiest swing in the world, and his card is always a monster no matter what. Number four, you give it to Joe Adell. And then number five would be Edgar Martinez because it's very easy to find a power hitting third baseman. Not so easy to find a good all around power hitting center fielder like Joe Adell. But that's going to be it when it comes to Battle Royale. Another cool thing that they added is now you get to see how many times your opponent has gone flawless, if they've gone flawless more than 5 times, which I think is a pretty cool feature to add. And it definitely makes the incentive to go flawless a lot better rather than just getting more stubs, which is also an enormous reason to go flawless. But it makes it even cooler, I want to say. But that's going to be it for today's video. If you did end up enjoying today's content, make sure you guys hit that like button, red subscribe button. Don't forget to follow me on all social medias at Blademus. And as always, have a blessed day and night. Stay positive, stay safe, stay blessed, stay healthy too. And I'll catch you all in the next one. Peace out.